Hi there, I'm Christopher Harrison. I'm a senior program manager inside of Microsoft Cloud and AI. And in this section, I want to take a look at how we can write if statements and some Boolean logic inside of JavaScript. So let's get right on into it. So when it comes to comparing values or Boolean logic inside of JavaScript, what you're going to notice is that the operators for less than, greater than, less than equal, greater than equal are pretty consistent with all programming languages. That you can see them all right there, and there's really no surprises. But what you're going to notice, though, is that I've left equals off. And the reason that I did that is because equals behaves a little bit differently inside of JavaScript. Now, one big thing to know about JavaScript is the fact that it will try to help you out as the developer by automatically doing data type conversions. And while this might be something that you're looking for, it's very infrequent. Typically, this is not the behavior that we expect. And so as a result, this can actually lead to bugs in code. So JavaScript gives us two different comparison operators. We've got the double equals and we've got the triple equals. Now, in the case of the double equals, what's going to happen is it will automatically do a conversion there. So as a result, the string of 42 would actually be equal to the number of 42. Probably not what we were expecting. But if we use the triple equals, now those two values are not going to be equal because one is a string and the other one is a number. This is typically the behavior that we're expecting. And so as a general best practice, you should always use the triple equals. That's going to be giving you what you expect when you do your comparisons. Now, as you also might expect, our not equal operator, we just simply put in a bang in or exclamation point in front of the equals. And again, that's going to be a regardless of data type. And then the bang two equals is going to check for that as well as the data types. So there's our not equal operators. And again, just like before, our best practice is always use the bang and then the double equals after, because that's really actually going to be all three. So that will be checking for both the values and the data types there. Again, that's typically what we want. When it comes to the if statement logic, the way that we build up an if statement is we say if whatever our condition is inside of parentheses, and then what we want to have happen on the true side inside of that curly braces. So in our case, with our status being 200, it's going to print out console.log, or it's going to run the code console.log and okay. So the printout would be okay in this case. Now, if it turned out that it was a value other than 200, then it's going to start stepping down from there. So it would look at the next else if, the next else if, the next else if, until it eventually runs out of items and gets to that else. That else at the very bottom winds up becoming a catch-all there. So if it's not 200 or not 400, then it would print out that unknown status down at the very bottom. It's worth highlighting here that in JavaScript, similar to other languages like Java, C Sharp, TypeScript, if what you're doing is a single line of code, then you can actually skip the curly braces. So I could actually, in that case, just simply write if status equals equals 200, console.log okay, do my else if right below it, and do my else right below that. And that actually gives me the exact same logic as this right here, just in slightly less space. Now, some developers like this. I personally don't use this because it can actually lead to some potential errors later on. So I typically don't use it. I know some developers like it, and that's why it's there. So that way you can see other options. The last one that I want to take a look at is what's known as the ternary or potentially instant or inline if statement. And so what this would do is it's actually going to do our check right here in the middle. You'll see that status equals 200. This is going to be the check. And if it turns out that it's true, then it's going to give us back the okay. And if it turns out that it's false, then it would wind up giving us back the error. And that value would then wind up inside of message. This is definitely one of those where it's better if we see it. So let's get in, write some code, and take a look at all of this in action.